touchdown. Whoever thought I'd have a buzz down, still sticking to the strip for D.
From beautiful South Florida, there's a look at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. The excitement brewing here in South Florida. As a moment ago, the Dolphins starters were introduced to this home crowd. They're fired up as well as they get set to match up with the Indianapolis Colts. Seems like we were just starting training camp, but here we are in October, and off we go on EA Sports. And here's Rodgers to return. And the tackle going to be made right there at the 25-yard line. Way forward for about four. Second and six.
Well, the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
Taylor's got the first down and more. And he is finally out of bounds all the way down at the 30. 42 yards rushing for him now to this point. Well, welcome to the party. First carry of the game. How about that?
And just think, as far as he's concerned, he's just getting warmed up.
So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Here's Wentz to throw. That's going to be caught by Allie Cox. Touchdown, Colts! Mo Allie Cox, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Colts take it right down and score on the opening drive. And his kick is no good. An inauspicious start here kicking-wise as this one stays a 6-0 game. Back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. First and 10, Brissett. This one complete to Jalen Waddle. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 16 yards right off the bat and a first down.
Defense gets up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. One play has him to the 37 here for first and 10. Brissett now. Flush to his right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. This defense for the Colts, they were terrific in the win over Tennessee a week ago.
And I don't know what the actual percentages are, and I don't know the analytics when you create five turnovers or takeaways in a game. But coaches always say, when you create a number that high, your chances of winning probably up over 98%. I haven't seen that number quantified, but I believe them.
Line of scrimmage, again the 37 as they line up second and 10. They just get the playoff. Now Brissett. He'll get this into the hands of Travis Fulgham. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. They go play action with Brissett. Got his man. It's the tight end Long. And he is going to have the Dolphins first down as they're able to convert on third and short yardage with a gain of four.
That throw's not going to get them a whole lot, but that really didn't matter, did it? They got what they needed on that throw. Picked up the first down, and I'm going cliche here. Game of inches, partner.
Absolutely. Well, and you talked to me a lot about opening drives, how key those are to set the tone. You kept the drive alive. Third down conversion here is big. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. And they will finally catch him, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there. The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Let's go. Now Brissett. Forced out to his left toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal.
58, right over there. Yeah. Mike, 58, right there. Right here. 58, Mike.
Don't let him breathe. Again, it's Brissett. Throwing for his running back, and he's got it complete. They'll get this halfway home from the 8 to the 4 on a gain of 4.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Gaskin, and he will push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line, and no hesitation about this decision here. Confidently, they're going to go for this fourth and goal from the 3. To throw, Brissett flushed out right. And this is caught by Parker for a Miami touchdown. Devontae Parker, his second touchdown on the season. And the Dolphins have tied it. Now they can take the lead with the extra point. And that is off the left upright. It's no good.
That ties the game 6-6.
So back even at 6 apiece as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Come to the line ready to start their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offense that's humming.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Second and six, just inside the 30. From the gun, it's Taylor. And this will go for five up to the 33.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
A 5-yard pickup on the play. And it's third down.
Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Now the Dolphins are going to take another timeout here. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. Looking to throw on third and two. Oh, he's got his tight end, Mo Alie-Cox, complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Three catches now this afternoon, the same number he had all of last week. Also, it's a first down.
And the Colts, first down.
Now a give to Taylor, and he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. And my goodness, they're now out of timeouts here in this first quarter. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Now it's Hines. And he's got some space here. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Naeem Hines, his second touchdown on the season. And the Colts have taken the lead. Now Blankenship on for the PAT. And we'll see if this rain affects the team's decisions going forward, but they kick it here, and it's good.
Dolphins 6.
So after the touchdown, here's Blankenship kicking off. Taking it about the one. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger, a really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds, because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but they make them out of bounds. That does you no good.
Brissett's throw here taken in by Parker. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Brissett. Out to the flat. That's complete to his running back. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. 3 yards the gain there, second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
Second and six. No, scratch that. Second and seven. Brissett sets to throw it. Escaping the pressure right. The Colts are going to get him. Down he goes.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
On third down, Brissett. He's going to float this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Now, that's a good bounce back after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive. Just one first down permitted and then out. Obviously, no loss of confidence with that defense, and now they get to turn it back to their offense.
This offense converted once already in this first quarter. They're going to try it again here on fourth down. They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. That's to his running back, complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive? Now from Colts territory, here's a first and 10 at the 48-yard line. Brissett. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that tuck rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward, incomplete pass. Second and 10. Throwing, Brissett. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Grover Stewart